I'm trying to make it out my city, cause my city killer. Trips to Anguilla, far from jungles with gorillas. I gotta make it for the simple fact I'm not a quitter. Rest in peace to Terry Berry, one real nigga. Whole lot of niggas hate like racism, so I dive inside my own dreams for escapism. It's gotta be a better way, I need some better days, instead of red tape with blood stains where bodies lay. I seen a nigga get arrested just yesterday. The streets are chess, not checkers, so we call the case. The streets is not a game, it ain't no replay. When bodies decay, then meet the pearly gates. I'ma make it to the top, so I keep the faith and keep away from snakes, middle fingers to the jakes. If you starving, most niggas won't feed you food or give a helping hand, so you must believe in you.
Well, I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Well, I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Well, I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Nobody really understands love.
Little homie malnourished, he ain't got dinner. And his mama shooting dope summer through the winter. That kind of shit'll make the little shorty so bitter. And he'll probably kill a nigga for a chicken tender. When the last time he ate, shit he can't remember. Landlord said the rent passed through since December. Same clothes the youngin' wearing like every week. And he don't want no night sneaks, man, he wanna eat. Coming up in the ghetto made his heart numb. Went from a 25 to a 9 with a drum. I know this chick, but she really need a brain, man. But it seems as if the girl won't change, man. With this nigga, that nigga, that nigga. Slim fat nigga, white nigga, black nigga. It don't even really matter, nigga. Planning out steps just to make her pockets fat.
Right. What's happening, y'all? It's your boy DC Curry coming to you live from Uptown Comedy Corner, the new improved Uptown in the ATL. You're listening to DISRACE. DISRACE, where our motto is no hate,
no fear.
But no fear. You got to know when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to walk away.
And we never run.
We don't do no running. Respect all.
Fear none.
And fear none. I got my main man, Lil Bo P, to my far left.
I ain't little no more, but I'm Bo P in the house. Who the hell?
I got light-skinned Bullhead to my far right.
Yo, what am? Peace and blessings.
I got the Mohican minister with no Mohican no more. Ladies and gentlemen, Brian Harper.
Always winning, never losing.
That's funny every time we hear it.
Amen. It is. You tell him.
I got actress, promoter, producer, community activist extraordinaire, Sister JJ to my left.
I'm here.
What's happening, Sister JJ?
Thank you so much. Thank you, DC. I love being here.
You have a good week?
I had an excellent weekend. How about you?
Yeah. Today, best day of my life.
DC.
Tomorrow gonna be better.
Would I be wrong for saying it's good to have Poussey in the house?
It's good. Always good to have Poussey
in the house.
I guess you still sold out.
No, I didn't. I'm waiting on my orders to come in.
If y'all haven't gotten any, you make sure you get some Sister JJ Poussey.
Yes.
Yes, because as soon as she get it, it is sold.
Yeah. She's along always with a bustier.
I got my good bra on today. Good cry, Brian, minister.
Hey,
good stuff.
Hey, just hey, it's obvious. You're
supposed to bow your head and close your eyes.
Or if I bow my head, then it just puts me in the yay of the bustier.
That's because your eyes ain't closed. You know?
If your that's the part I'm missing.
If your eyes were closed, you wouldn't see all
okay,
that.
All right. Got it. Eyes are closed, man.
He one of them lay hand ministers. He don't.
Let me touch these. This weekend at the church, I'll be giving free mammograms. I'll be checking for lumps.
We got to see what's in your heart. What's in your heart?
Ah, what a lie. Off air, we were talking about one of the biggest lies you ever heard in your life. I knew when that girl said she pulled over to help the little white baby
I said, that ain't right.
That ain't right.
But did she say white baby?
Yeah.
Yeah. And underwear. White baby with white Pampers.
Oh, okay.
Diapers.
Walking up the interstate, 600 yards.
I just thought it was a baby. I didn't know it was a white baby.
Yeah, white
yeah,
baby.
Yeah, man. It's Hoover.
Because if it was a black baby, you know, wouldn't nobody believe that. Because black baby, that. They would have arrested him.
Yeah.
Police would have picked him up.
Yeah.
For walking on the
highway. They arrested the black baby for lottery.
That's it.
They got here for jaywalking.
Exactly.
Yeah, she claimed she's driving down the highway in Alabama. Saw a little baby pull over to help the baby. Got on the phone, called a friend.
Mm-hmm.
And then
called 911. Supposedly.
And she screamed, disappeared. Later on, they found the car. Car door open. She
has
gone.
The lights on, yeah. The thing was, I guarantee you, she did not count on the video of her car driving on the side of the road for about 600 yards on that highway, and nobody saw any baby.
Mm-hmm.
So and she had her blinkers on.
Yeah, she had her hazard lights on. And then the 911 call said, we've been trying to reach her, and she hadn't responded since she hung up the phone. So just a lot of red flags.
I said something wasn't right.
You know.
And then finally they said.
They hauled off and said that there's no abduct. They did a release today. The police chief of Hoover said that there's no kidnapper to be found.
Hoover, Alabama. That's where the comedy, what's the name of it, Bo?
Hoover.
Bruce's play. Bruce Ayers.
Stardom.
Stardom. Yeah.
Mm.
Right there, Hoover, Alabama.
Right. But don't y'all think it's sad that there are 75,000 missing black women in the United States right now?
Mm-hmm.
Finally, we ask for the attention that we're supposed to get, and when they give it to us,
you abuse
it's like a
it.
Slap in our face. Yes.
Yeah, you abuse it.
Mm-hmm. You know?
And that's what I was going to say. That's just terrible that she would do that because for a side piece.
Yeah, tell the story first. Tell the story for the people that don't know. They came anyway. Come to truth be told, now they're saying that she was
stole
some
stuff from work.
She had a side piece. She stole some stuff from work. Mm-hmm. Go ahead, Brian.
Well, the thing is that as they put stuff together, that she had left work and that she stole some items from work and. Then she went by Target and picked up some items like snacks and everything like that. All the while, the FBI said her recent search was watching the movie Taken. Then she Googled how to get money if people donated to certain funds for restitution. So with that being 10 minutes outside and then her finally accepting her boyfriend, she had blocked him. Up until the video that showed her was on the side of the road, then she unblocked the boyfriend when she had gone out of town or went missing. We can't say she went out of town, but she had unblocked the boyfriend.
So my question is she going to be declared mental illness? Because, you know, when white people do it, they'd be like, they have a mental problem. So will she be declared mental ill?
Well, right now, the Hoover Police Department, to me, I think they're silent about it and they're building a case. Because they're not forcing her to talk, but eventually this young lady is going to have to talk. Like, they won't even put it in front of a camera because when she first returned, the boyfriend released a statement saying she fought for her life. So, of course, people now want to see if you fought for your life because you're fighting for your life, you've been abducted, should be some bumps and bruises. But the paper said that she went to UAB for an evaluation. Not treatment, but for an evaluation. So it was just red flag after red flag that came up.
Yeah, I never watched the movie Chucky. That little white baby beat her ass. Y'all never watched the movie Chucky. Nobody can find Chucky.
I ain't gonna say I don't think she could. Chucky struggled with the white woman in the movie. I don't think Chucky could have got the best of this sister. This sister's an AKA. Part of Divine Nine.
You know, they say
she's
an AKA female. NRN.
A nickname is what?
They're going to kick her out.
Female Jessie Smollett.
Jessie Smollett.
Yes.
They're going to kick her
she
out.
She might top him because that was up until now. That was the biggest lie in the history of lies.
Yeah.
It was.
Yeah. She might be the new Jessica Smollett.
Nah, that's the second biggest one.
Huh?
First one was Rosewood.
First biggest one was what?
Rosewood. When a white lady said that the black man raped her and the whole town guy.
Well, that's in a different category.
I'm talking about.
Oh, black folks lie. Yeah, you know, that's the
another big lie to a white woman. She just died. They claim, what the boy they lynched?
Emmett Till.
Emmett Till.
She admitted before she died that it was she made that shit up.
Black folks lies. Yes, she went.
Hey, she was like, she admitted, I guess she saw Say said. I guess Say said, yeah. Oh, hold on. Let me tell this whole truth before it's out. I
mean, you still going.
Say she's still going.
She
was like, you mean tell me I'm going to hell and Emmett Till went to heaven?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You still going.
She came clean for a reason, you know. And
whatever.
You know, so it's came for a reason. Never know, man.
But this girl, she really put a dent in, like you said, JJ. Brian has said, what'd you say, 75,000 black women missing?
75,000 black women are missing right now.
And I've seen shows raising hell about them not getting the attention like missing white women get.
Mm-hmm.
And now this.
Exactly. Like you always see the white person, the white child, and you barely ever see black boys, black men, black women. In my magazine, I always post the black man or in the men magazine and in the women, a black
child. Wait a minute, JJ. Come on now. When black men missing, it's on purpose.
Well, you know, now these days, they're coming for your organs.
Coming back.
They're coming for your organs.
He got warrants.
Remember that magazine in St. Louis where they would post everybody in jail? Remember that magazine? They would post everybody.
They put everybody out of jail. You got a mugshot, they knew.
St. Louis, they would post everybody.
And then the second thing was child support.
Yeah,
it's a big thing in Virginia. You owe child support, you going in the newspaper.
Is that right?
They put you in the newspaper.
It must be a thick ass paper.
No, what's that gonna do though? You ain't paid your bills.
Who was it they said the other day owed $700,000?
Wow.
Wasn't Tyrese? It was
that old 700K?
700,000.
Oh my goodness.
And child support?
Yeah, who was it that acted in them car movies with You mean fast car movies?
You had Tyrese.
That's Tyrese now.
Tyrese.
Mm-hmm.
Golly.
$700,000 behind.
Them cars wasn't fast enough.
And they took more than that.
Huh?
I heard they took more than that.
I don't know if he had $700,000, but
that's a lot of money.
I know he was crying about it when he came out of court.
Well, what about Kevin Costner going through a divorce and the lady wanted $250,000 a month for child support? Now, what the hell them children eat? Gold? And the court gave her $127,000, I think it was.
Yeah. The kids got to live like the father.
But that's what they say.
So the father needed to get him a one-bedroom
studio
apartment.
They made her get out of his house, because that was his house. They had a prenup.
Yeah.
And she trying to say the prenup don't count. And right before she filed for divorce, they saying it was all premeditated. 6 months before she filed for the divorce, she took $100,000 and went and bought her a car. Because in the prenup, it said that she gets to keep her car if they ever get divorced. Right. So she went and bought her brand new car for their divorce.
She did a prime deal.
Yeah, they say she spent $100,000.
Let me get that AMG
on the housekeeper's money. He had an account for the housekeeper, you know, when they wait from the house.
Right.
She took that credit card and bought $100,000 worth of shit.
Consuela, let me use your card.
She went shopping before she left. Yeah, I'm going to get everything.
Like, I was going to say no.
I don't think I know nobody. Well, I'm sure I do know somebody.
I was going to say, you know a lot of people.
I don't know of nobody I know that got a prenup. Y'all ever had one?
I ain't got nothing to have no prenup.
It could be the other way around. Your wife could have made you sign one so you don't take her money.
I know somebody's got a prenup, but they don't say it.
We ain't got enough money. We try to pay bills. We ain't think about no damn prenup.
Hey, for me and my five marriages, it was for richer or for poorer. Until death do us part.
You've been married five times, do that.
Yeah.
God, I don't know if I should praise you or punch you.
Yeah.
You still ain't figured it out.
I told people I ain't no quitter.
You ain't no winner.
You ain't
either.
No starter. Like, you ain't a good starter either.
Man, you been married five times. How many times you been divorced?
Five.
Four.
Yeah, think about that, boy. You ain't no, bigamist, are you, boy?
No, I don't get along.
How much time was there between the marriages and the divorces?
So for the first four, it's probably like less than a year.
Yeah.
The last one, it took me about 6 years to.
Find another food.
I'm about to be real salty right now. Well, so was any of your second or third wife the prior side chick while you was married to one of them?
Yeah.
We don't do side chicks.
I'm just saying.
I can handle
it. Was you already talking to one of them?
I don't know what he going
to
say.
As you was married?
Well, I won't call him a side chick. I just called him my next wife.
They were friends.
Okay, all right, okay. All right, associates. So there was some prior interaction.
He's saying that. Tomato, tomato.
So what I'm saying is when I end a relationship, legally or not, it's over. And, if I had my next wife, then I was with my next wife.
Mm. Okay. I'm gonna see if I can get away with
but
that.
She wasn't no side chick because I never cheated on any of them.
Right, right. I get it. I know what you mean. I just trying to see if there was a.
Well, I'm like, what's his name say? Playing ball. If you ain't cheating, you ain't trying.
Oh Lord, DC.
Not trying to
what
move on.
What's name said that?
Patriots.
New Patriots. Yeah. If you ain't cheating, you ain't trying.
Oh Lord.
They said racing. If you ain't bumping, you ain't driving. Mm-hmm. What do you call it? Well, you ain't
rubbing
bumping,
and
you ain't
racing.
I am either, bullhead. I've been accused of.
What's that?
I've been accused of
having a next wife. In your terms, he's been accused of having a next wife.
Okay.
I've been falsely accused, man. I feel for brother locked up and stuff because, I never been locked. Well, I have been locked up over a false accusation.
Yeah.
But being falsely accused of something, man,
it's not a good feeling. It is not a good feeling.
Take a toll on you, no matter what you've done, because I had done some other shit.
But I
hadn't
do
done
that.
What I was accused of.
Right.
And what I went to jail.
Right.
Well, my third wife, she threw me in jail for a night. And then when she finally realized that I was going to get 3 years, then she started changing the story and shit. Mm.
Yeah, because you can't pay no alimony.
You got to be
forever
indebted to her.
Well, no, not alimony. She was worried about the child support.
Yeah. Can't pay it if you're in jail.
Right. So then all of a sudden, we go to court and she don't want to testify against me.
You ever had a man locked up, JJ?
Mm-mm.
All right, you ain't got to say it like that. Most black women have. You ain't got to say it like it's a ridiculous question.
I ain't had to get you locked up.
Huh?
I ain't had to get him locked up.
So the J say, no. They're going to behave. As soon as they see my bustier.
We did street justice.
Well, I almost went to
but
jail.
But my ex-husband, though, he almost got locked up, but that was because of him.
He
kept crying in front of the judge. I'm like, dude, what you crying for?
Crying.
Dang. Now, Sister Jane,
When I got locked up going through my divorce, man, I did like, my favorite movie, The Godfather. I just did like The Godfather. I had already thought they was going to lock me up, man. And the judge said, take him into custody, man. I started taking my jewelry off. My nephew was in. I took my jewelry off, handed it to my nephew. Come up here, man. Come up here and gave him a truck key. Mm-hmm. It was full of gas, too. When I got out of jail, that son of a bitch was empty.
I'm riding around, no spinning.
Okay.
Man, they dog, they over in D.C. I'm in my home in D.C. home, man.
Hey, what do you do with your jewelry?
He probably wearing it now. I don't know.
He flexing, boy.
He probably wearing it now. I don't remember, man.
Hey, that joker putting up
but
the light like this.
I know my truck was on empty. I had a Hummer. It was on E, bro. It was full when I went to jail.
he took the long route home.
He drove the whole weekend with the window down, arm out.
Where the hell he going 2 days, man?
No, man.
Mississippi?
Flexing. I got rings and watch.
Yeah.
Oh, hold on.
I gotta say, DC, I said it 4 times. I'm gonna say it 5 times. I love that hat.
Damn, JJ stuck on my hat.
I'm trying to tell you, DC, that hat is it.
Yeah.
Huh? Yeah. Yes, Erica, that hat is it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. All right. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
I mean, it's all right. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I'm just all right.
No,
I gave him props before the show.
Yeah.
Man, that thing ain't popping, man. I'm telling you. You ain't got to say nothing. The hat is talking.
Yes.
To the audience.
Hey, when I saw it, I thought about Black
Pride. It's giving life.
Black Pride.
Sir.
You
Black Pride. Black Pride.
Gucci? Nah, bro.
Look at the colors.
Oh, you trying to go all the way back to the African medallion.
That's right.
Now, that's the red, black, and the green.
You just scared me. I didn't hear what you said first. You said that pride.
what I saw.
No, I said Black Pride. I didn't say no other pride.
I know, but I didn't hear what you said.
Yeah, I can kind of relate, though.
When I saw it, I thought about Black Prime.
Black Prime.
Yeah, Prime said you got it on Prime this weekend.
What?
Oh my God.
Man, y'all hate
Erica,
on me.
Got it on yes, Prime. Erica, that head is giving
it's always, life. It's always haters, JJ.
Yes, haters.
JJ like it. And Erica like it.
I love it.
I can give a damn what you think, Kofi.
I love the hat.
It's giving life. I'm
I love
just
the hat
because
I saw that Goodwill tag on the back, but I love the hat.
What's wrong with Goodwill?
Oh my God, it's on Goodwill.
What's wrong with Goodwill?
Nah, that's authentic.
What's wrong with Goodwill?
I get a lot of good stuff from Goodwill.
I bought stuff from Goodwill. Nah, I wouldn't buy no hat, though.
Nah, I wouldn't buy no hat either.
What they call it? The tetis.
Yeah.
Yes.
Lice.
I don't want the tennis.
Yeah, got some old bed bugs or something.
I get a lot of good stuff from Goodwill, man.
Man, I bought golf clubs at Goodwill, artwork.
Yeah, be careful which Goodwill you go to, though. You can't go to anyone.
No, you got to go out there where people don't need it.
Right. Yeah. Right.
They got one in Peachtree City. It'd be some brand new shit in there.
they got one in the hood over there. They just be throwing stuff on the ground.
You got
outside.
One in Decatur if you want to.
That stuff be on the ground outside, so they pick through it.
You know, growing up in Chicago, we used to go up to Evanston and Highland Park.
Yeah.
And go to all those little churches.
Yeah.
And, man, they had some nice stuff up in there.
Speaking of which, when we come back, my main man, Jesse Jackson, calling it a day. He stepped down from Breadbasket. We'll be back. You're listening to DISRACE.
Jesse, ain't he sleep?
Oh, my God.
Damn it.
Trying to make it out my city, cause my city killer. Trips to Anguilla, far from jungles with gorillas. I gotta make it but a simple fact, I'm not a quitter. Rest in peace to Terry Berry, one real nigga.
Whole lot of niggas hate like racism. So I dive inside my own dreams for escapism. It's gotta be a better way. I need some better days. Instead of red tape with blood stains where bodies lay. I seen a nigga get arrested just yesterday. The streets are chess, not checkers, so we call the case. The streets is not a game, it ain't no replay. When bodies decay, then meet the pearly gates. I'ma make it to the top, so I keep the faith. And keep away from snakes, middle fingers to the jakes. If you starving, most niggas won't feed you food. Never give a helping hand, so you must believe in you.
Well, I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Seen nothing but trouble, baby. Well, I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Nobody really understands. No, no.
Little homie malnourished, he ain't got dinner. And his mama shooting dope summer through the winter. That kind of shit'll make the little shorty so bitter. And he'll probably kill a nigga for a chicken tender. When the last time he ate, shit he can't remember. Landlord said the rent passed through since December. Same clothes the youngin' wearing like every week. And he don't want no night sneaks, man, he wanna eat. Coming up in the ghetto made his heart numb. Went from a 25 to a 9 with a drum. I know this chick, but she really need a brain, man. But it seems as if the girl won't change, man. With this nigga, that nigga, that net. Slim fat nigga, white nigga, black nigga. It don't even really matter, nigga. Planning out steps just to make a pocket fat.
Well, I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Well, I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Seen nothing but trouble, baby. Nobody really understands. I go to the place where danger awaits me.
What that is, D?
Jamie Foxx doing better.
Oh, wow, that's good. Man,
he's been seen two or three places in Chicago on a boat, stopped, lady dropped a pocketbook. He picked the pocketbook up, got out the car, gave her a pocketbook. Mm-hmm. He's seen playing pickleball.
Girl, get comfortable. Tell him, Jamie Foxx.
Yeah.
Glad to see him out.
He got a new movie coming
glad
out, too.
To see him out.
She wants some Marvin Gaye.
But they say he's still in rehab, so I don't get
Luther
it.
Luther Vandross.
He looked, he was at the golf course, hitting bone.
But he want to get him back to his motorcycle.
He probably still is in rehab, but, you know, he's able to come out a little bit more.
Right.
He probably still not finished treatment.
Yeah.
But he still can, you know, get out.
Well, they still ain't telling what it was. But apparently it was a stroke.
Possibly. Maybe the same thing that happened to Jamie was happened to the linebacker from the Patriots, Teddy Bruschi. Remember me some years ago, he was playing football and had a stroke. It took him like some time to kind of come back, and he had to rehab and kind of get his instincts
What's
back.
What's the name that almost died, or they say died for a minute and came back? Now he say he come back to play.
Mm-hmm. DeMar Hamlin.
DeMar Hamlin.
Yes.
I don't think he should come back to play.
I don't either. I wouldn't.
You know,
when you train all your life or something like that, man, you know, you played sports. I mean, we played hurt. even if we weren't even getting paid.
Died.
We were in high school. We was in high school.
Died. We never die and come back.
Yeah, he died.
Well, he's probably looking at it because of the injury is so rare and the type of injury it was, and he probably got in his head like, you know, I'm gonna die some kind of way. Why not do it?
Oh, my.
Man, I've heard people say that. I got to die sometime.
I mean,
way.
Some
okay.
people don't. I agree with it now. Like, oh, before you get on me, I would probably be over there like, hey, I'm done. Thank y'all for the donation. I can go into broadcasting or something or coaching. But, hey, he just want to play.
But, you know, you look at Tua Tagovailoa, how you say his name, Tua Tagovailoa.
Yeah.
They told him, you know.
Tua Tagovailoa.
Why take a chance like that? I mean, that's like going down in the submarine because you got the money, man.
Well, DC, you know, when these guys get hurt with knee injuries, like look at Klay Thompson, basketball player. Mm-hmm. He had knee injuries back to back to back. He was out of basketball for
that
almost
ain't the
4
same.
Years.
That ain't the same.
But I'm saying, but I'm saying the
literally
mentality.
Dying, your heart stopped beating.
But I'm saying, but the mentality of an athlete.
I understand.
That's a pro athlete.
I understand that. It's yeah. more evident in boxers than anything. They just can't. They can't quit. And then most of them end up with brain damage. You know.
The adrenaline rush from the fans is hard to replace that. And that's why
hell
a lot
with
of players.
That, man.
I'm not disagreeing, but I'm just
when
telling you what
you
keeps
up,
them on the field.
You run
why it's so hard to step away.
When you 200 sprints uphill, you lifting all these weights all day, you thinking you invincible, man.
And you found out
you ain't.
That you're not.
But if it wasn't for the video, he would have known what happened to him. He just, you know, you'd have been knocked out before the football field.
At worst.
Right.
Yeah.
At worst.
Yeah.
You don't even remember what happened to you. You was gone, man.
Yeah.
But I mean, he's probably like, yeah, I know what y'all said, but then somebody can say, like, well, it's really just an equivalent of a just grade 3 concussion. I know it sounds insane to us because we looked at him as he died. But again, man. When that's something that you
have
just
more
played
a concussion,
for,
his heart stopped beating.
I understand
his mind,
that,
be so
but in
up.
His mind, it's the same. If I don't remember what happened and I wake up, that's to him in his mind, he's convinced himself that's just
a
severe concussion.
Well, he must have had a grade 17 concussion if he think he should go back to NFL. And I'm telling you something, man. Them boys in the NFL don't be playing, bro.
No. Oh, no, it's violent, man.
It's a violent sport.
They don't be playing, man. I'm telling you,
the only
man.
Thing I can match to it is MMA. But NFL, that's a violent sport. You
it's
got guys 300
pounds. What's his name? Muscle Man that replaced Tiny Lister in the Friday movie.
Terry Crews.
Terry Crews told me, you know, he was in the NFL. Mm-hmm. Terry Crews told me they used to place bets.
On who he get?
Who could knock themselves? Who could knock their self out?
Well,
they try to hit a man so hard, it knocked them out.
They're idiots.
So the
to
coach
me.
Wouldn't be happy. If you're not somebody to come back to the sideline, the coach, boy, that's how you run.
But I will say the game is physical enough to one time, Steven Jackson, the running back for the Rams.
Yeah.
And man, they gave him a handoff. But he took the two-hole, the four, and when he bounced outside, he was moving he was so big and so fast. And when my brother came up to hit him, when he dropped his shoulder and dropped his knee, my brother's helmet left his face and came back
to
him.
Who is your brother?
Roman Harper, safety for the Saints. Who that? But back to the story. they went out of bounds. It was a very violent hit. Steven Jackson pops up. He claps his hand, does the little kind of point thing. My brother gathers himself. And then he walks toward the trainer. The impact was so hard that it like broke his nose. But when I looked at it, that was so impactful and so physical that if they had $2 million in a suitcase on the 50-yard line, I would not hit that dude. Like I told Roman right there, I said, you get paid, you deserve whatever you get paid, because there's no way I would have came up and made that play.
And now
he hit him so hard, you said, mama, don't buy that house.
Oh, he went right back out there. They reset his nose, and he went back out there and they won. But
oh, my God.
But yeah, they just reset his nose and went back out there and won. But me seeing it and how fast it was and being right there on top of it and how fast and how big Steven Jackson could move, Somebody said, hey, Lil Harper, we'll give you $2 million in a suitcase to hit that guy. I'm like, nah, because I mean, his that would probably kill me.
I don't know, $2 million, man.
They call it what?
No, DC.
What they call it, a career, when you decide to do it? Is it
it's a career decision.
Career decision. Career decision right there. Yeah,
hey, you got to know when to hold them.
I play, but not at the NFL level.
You got to know when to hold them and know when to fold them.
Yeah.
Roman said
his first introduction was when he was at practice. And being at Alabama, he used to jump up and knock the ball down when the quarterback threw the ball. He said, but in the NFL, the offensive linemen are so athletic that when he tried to knock the ball down, they just grabbed him and slammed him. He said if he had not got paid that day, he would have quit. But it's just like, because he couldn't breathe. And the offensive lineman said, hey, don't jump in the league, rookie. Don't ever leave your feet.
I know, boy.
And so he got paid that day, and that what kept him going.
And there's a true story. I played baseball with a guy, Leon Winfrey. Fastest man I ever seen in my life was Ricky Peters. But Leon Winfrey.
Is he from Texas?
No, he's from South Georgia. Okay. Fastest man I ever seen in my life. But he tried out and made the team for the Falcons. And he said.
Speed kills.
He said in his first game, he was a.
Kick returner?
Kick returner.
Yeah, that's what he
said.
He
said they hit him. He said he got up and ran straight to the locker room and took that shit on.
And quit.
Hell no.
You know what?
Hey, man, I'm taking a speed kill.
Where my Burger King suit at?
I can relate to that because I tried to be a running back in high school, Park High School.
Yeah.
And we had this linebacker named... We called him Cocaine, because he was crazy.
Right.
Man, that dude knocked me out so bad. Look, I saw stars and birds and all that, like in the cartoons, right. And then I became a swimmer.
Hey, man, it's some guys that it ain't for you, man. Yeah, it ain't for you, man.
Guys don't be playing, man. Yeah. Don't be playing, man. That's all you got to do is eat and lift and train. And now it's worse, because now, you know, back in the day, Dick Buckus and them, They had raw strength, but they wasn't trained like these guys now. You got doctors, you got dieticians, you got machines. They tracking your heart rate,
coaching techniques, way to tackle now. Is a lot.
Everything, yeah. All that.
Strength conditioners.
That shit is dangerous, man. Shit is dangerous. Right. You know, hey man, a good athlete, I admire him, but when something like that happened, you cannot put your life on the line for no sport. I wouldn't. And I think this boy Messi that's come over here, he's in Miami now, $60 million a year.
Living it.
For soccer, but which living goes it. To show you, I do not understand soccer that well, because ain't no way in hell I can imagine paying man $60 million to kick no damn ball.
It's the world's game.
I don't know what Pelé made. I know it's the world. I be trying Pelé. I be trying to watch it. I mean, I done got a little more educated, but I cannot see $59 million difference between him and what's the boy for Atlanta make $1 million. Yeah. I can't see it.
Soccer
make more
money than football.
Yeah, I know that.
Or even more.
I know that. Yeah. I mean,
he's 40 million more than Steph Curry.
I can validate it because they putting ass in them seats. Right. But just as far as athletic ability and talent, I'm gonna tell you something else. I played baseball. The money that some of them guys make, in basketball, I can rationalize it more. Football, I can rationalize more than baseball. In baseball, first place, you cannot score in baseball unless you on offense, unless you bat. Football, you can intercept ball and score. Basketball, you can you cannot score in baseball unless you at bat.
Right.
Then in baseball, you can't hit but one time, and you got to let eight other guys hit.
Come around. Yeah.
Then on defense, you can't catch the ball unless it come to you.
That's true.
Yeah, but you're playing. How many games? You deserve it. I mean, you're playing a whole bunch of
two games.
Yeah, that's a lot, man.
Yeah, I mean, but I'm still saying you cannot. It's circumstantial, man. You can't. I don't give a damn how good a glove you got, how good an arm you got. You can't catch the ball and throw the ball unless it come your way. I don't give a damn how much you can hit. You can't hit until it's your turn to bat, as opposed to basketball where they can give you the ball every time.
So, what's the Japanese guy play for the Angels? Real good.
I was about to ask him, how much do you think Otani's worth?
Otani's going to get. He's going to be the highest paid athlete in the world. Yeah.
Oh, I ain't mad at him.
Otani is ridiculous.
I ain't mad at him on the business tip, because my idea on the business tip is, if they getting that, if the owner pay a man $400 million, the only way he could do that
is if he's
bringing it in.
Yeah.
But now back to respect to soccer. It's a hard sport to play. You're using your feet. You can't use your hands.
And well, running.
They actually call it football.
That is running. Football.
Yeah. I mean, just running.
Running constantly.
Running.
Yeah.
Constantly. They are in great shape, man. They are great athletes, man. Yeah. To be able to do what they do with their feet.
$60 million a year.
How they can dribble that ball past that ball with their feet.
Crossover.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Running it's speed.
Yeah.
People sliding into your ankles.
Yeah. Yeah, but the thing is, look, but for the sports, which athlete spends more time training, playing, and everything else?
I would say basketball.
Not baseball?
No.
Training?
You spend a lot of time.
Football.
I mean,
football, on game day,
you have to 8 hours.
Right. I wouldn't say that.
I'd probably say MMA.
They do that, too.
Well, yeah. Fighting.
But if you're talking about the major one, then I'm going to say boxing. You spend more time training. If you're talking about out of all of them, or you're just talking about the top three,
they take off.
They take off until it's time to fight, man. They take 3 or 4 months for a fight, and they go hard. They don't take no showers. I got that from boxers.
Golly.
You know, when they be wrapping guy up and put his head under his arm? Yeah. Dude ain't had no shower in 3 months, man.
Yeah, they fight, they don't bathe.
But when they off, they off. They don't
brush their teeth. They want to make the other fighter as uncomfortable.
But I think basketball is sport where you can't, you know, football, you get a breather between plays.
Yeah, a little bit.
Baseball, you know, it's pretty much. But basketball, you got to get your ass up and down that court.
Bang.
Football is, I'm telling you, man, it's a year-round training. You guys,
you ain't got to be in shape like basketball.
Yeah, you do. DJ.
No, ain't no guys in the NBA that look like football players. I mean, and football players in great shape, but they ain't in. If basketball game is 100 to 100, you know, and you're averaging 2 points a shot, that means you done run up and down that court at least 150 times.
But let me say this on behalf of football, I'm not being biased.
You know what I'm saying?
You've seen football players, Tony Gonzalez, Jimmy Graham, guys like that play basketball. We ain't seen no basketball player go out there and play football in the pros.
It's more contact. But I'm talking about being
that's what I mean. So if you in shape, I'm in football shape. And if Tony Gonzalez played in the summer league in the NBA, saying like he's a football player. But you know what? I'm good enough to go over here and play in the summer league.
Oh, you can have an exception to the rule, but I'm just saying in general. Let me put it like this. I've known some fat football players. I ain't known no fat basketball players. I've seen some that were slightly overweight for a minute.
But that's what I'm saying. Football players are better athletes then.
No. They might be better. I'm talking about being in shape. I'm talking about running shape. We started talking about soccer, which I agree. You got to be in extraordinary shape.
Definitely.
And I was saying after that is probably basketball.
Mm-hmm.
And football is more of strength and agility. But as far as running your ass up and down the field, soccer and basketball.
Wide receivers and cornerbacks, nobody run more than them, man.
No, that's not true.
Cornerback.
That's not true. Let me tell you something, man.
Next to quarterback. Cornerback got to be the hardest.
That ain't true.
Hardest position to play.
Now, Brian know more than me, but I'm telling you.
Cornerback next to quarterback.
Let me tell you what I've seen, dog. Let me tell you what I've seen. I've known some football players. If the ball ain't coming your way, shit. Sometimes you tell that defensive man, I ain't in this play, man. Shit, let's trot down this damn.
You can't believe him.
I'm telling you.
Yeah,
you can't believe him.
I'm telling you, man. They take plays off, man.
Like, sometimes, man, look, man. Sometimes, man, when you out there, man, it's fourth quarter, dog. You line up there in the corner. And, man, you talking about, like, dude, you line up on me, finna press me, and you think the ball come my way? I'm like, hold on, dog.
I understand that.
You know, just talking.
But a cornerback. Yeah, it is so far communicating between us and the DB.
Especially if y'all like, hey, look, man,
you got a break between every play. Basketball, you could run up. I've seen him miss 10 shots in a row. You running your ass back and forth.
With no cornerback and wide receivers. run them 50 yards.
Oh, well, yeah,
down the field and come and back then, and got to do it again. Oh, yeah. Man,
yeah. Yeah. I'm saying you can't be in shape.
You got to be in shape. What you mean? I'm saying you can't.
No,
but do you remember those old shows when Chris Carter nine, and all them dudes used to do the dunk contest and all that stuff?
Yeah, they're athletes. I'm not debating.
Yeah, they're athletes.
I think you got to be in better shape.
What's that?
To play basketball. We'll be back.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you got to be safe.
Cornerback is the hardest position. You got to follow one of the fastest.
Bounce, bounce. Got to do it like I used to, bitch. I got to do it like I'm used to it. When I talk that G shit, I be too floored. I'm getting money, little nigga, what is you doing? I'm always trying to win, cause a nigga hate losing. Lost dang, it was crucial. He was the hardest in the city to be truthful. If you seen what I seen, you'll be neutral. This game gets brutal, but I'm big dog, you a poodle. Got a couple screws loose. If niggas ran in your career, what would you do? Probably lay on the ground and boo-hoo. I guess that's the difference between me and you. Been a G, still a G, and I'm active. I wouldn't be who I am if I was passive. Get a bag, then get it off.
What you know about going to school? Tying clothes, no washing, no dry. What you know about no lights, no water? Yeah, that make it hard. What you know about running to the bus stop trying to catch that morning? What you know about standing on that car and get that from my father? Remember days I couldn't sleep, couldn't talk about it with my mama. I ain't like how we was living, so I decided to chase them commas. We gon' get it, we gon' win. The struggle gotta end. I done shed so many tears. Can't let the pain get to my heart. I done been hurt, I done been scarred, but ain't no victim. If I'm being honest, then it's the truth, this a hard life.
Gotta be ready to die anytime, alright.
If he's standing next to me, you know he alright. I've been down in the struggle, I've been down in the struggle, I've been down in the struggle. I've been down in the struggle, I've been down in the struggle, I've been down in the struggle. I've been down in the struggle, I've been down in the struggle, I've been down in the struggle. I've been down in the struggle, I've been down in the struggle, I've been down in the struggle. Feel like a stray dog looking for some water. All the nightmares I done had, this shit fucked up my mental order. Could never play me, you a snapback cap, you a fitted. From the A, niggas already know it's wicked in my city. We put 50s on our Glock,
they start shooting at 13.
There's more angels on my block than it's dope in the street.
Thank you.
I never did get to the point where I was headed was Reverend Jesse Jackson is call it a day with Operation Push.
Yeah. Pray until something happens.
Step down. Who replaced that?
He done pushed to the side.
Yeah. He's
push it to the limit.
Yeah.
Who's his replacement?
Getting on up there in age.
Yeah, he's getting older.
Yeah, he was in a wheelchair at the ceremony with him.
Dang, Jesse?
Yeah.
That was just like wheelchair just for him to be comfortable, right? He can walk, right?
He's not going to be in the wheelchair because he want to be comfortable.
No. Hold up. We have wheelchair service. Thank you. We had wheelchair service at the airport, Sister J. So maybe he was just trying to be comfortable.
Nah. Mm-mm. I'm with you, Sister J.
You think he in the wheelchair written right now and can't walk?
Yeah. Or having trouble.
Jesse old.
Jesse 80s. Late 80s, man.
Yeah, man.
I don't think he's wearing it. Stop it. Written to a wheelchair, Jesse Jackson?
Yeah. So what do you think Jesse Jackson is?
Stop it, man.
As long as you see her here, what's wrong with that?
Man, look. Jesse was just at the dude Ahmaud Arbery's trial. Said no, he ain't had no wheelchair.
He probably walked too far.
Jesse Jackson last week, when he retired from Operation Push, is wheelchair bound. And from look on his face, he didn't know he was there or in the wheelchair.
Oh, God.
Stop it.
Reverend Frederick Douglass.
Hold up. Sister J got my back.
No, that wasn't looking that good either. Huh?
Reverend Frederick Douglass Haynes III took the reins of the Rainbow Push Coalition.
I don't know.
Frederick Douglass? The dude dead.
I don't know who he is.
Who, Frederick Douglass?
Frederick Douglass Haynes.
Not the one that you grew up with.
Well, you grew up.
Oh, okay. I like that.
The one you remember.
Okay.
Old Fred.
Yeah.
So, Jesse had a good run. He did a lot of good stuff.
He's 81 years old.
I think he can walk, though. I think you guys are going too far saying he can't walk.
I know people that's 81, but they're not in a wheelchair.
I think
you said he's 98. He ain't in no wheelchair.
Yeah. My dad is 83 and lived down the
Your
street.
Your daddy got the anointing on him.
Well, my dad 80, he in a wheelchair.
Huh?
My daddy in a chair now.
He's in a wheelchair now?
He can walk around, but he still uses a chair.
Yeah, that's what I mean. I think Jesse Jackson was just basically using the chair until he got through with the ceremony.
Obviously, you didn't see the ceremony.
I didn't, but I mean, we're talking about Jesse Jackson, people.
I don't give a damn who you're talking about. I'm talking about, I saw the man in the wheelchair.
Yeah, they don't do Methuselah age no more.
And he does not look like he can...
What?
Run at them girls.
Walk
no
at
more.
A reasonable, yeah. reasonably, you know. I mean, he's
does he look confined to the wheelchair or not?
Hey, man, go look at, Google it, man.
Huh?
Google it and look at the damn picture.
Yeah, he ain't all chasing right. no assistance. Yeah.
I thought Sister J was doing
it
right
I'm
there.
Telling you, he looked confined to the wheelchair.
Just throw it on YouTube. Huh?
I don't know why he can't
I'm sure they
that.
Got a YouTube video.
Yeah.
Because he's talking about Jesse Jackson pushing to some 80
years old. Why you can't believe that? Jesse done walked a lot of steps.
Yeah.
And them bad shoes they had on back then. Even my old Converse, they were flat
bottom. I'm looking at it
God
right
bless.
Now. Hold on.
God bless him. You looking at old picture if he's standing up?
No, I'm finna see it.
God bless him, but
oh Lord,
he was
here he is right here.
He was looking a little rough there. Yeah. Now do he look like he could stand up if he wanted to?
Hold on.
Yeah,
Jesse look comfortable
Jesse
in that chair.
Jesse Jackson. Hold on. Jesse Jackson uses a wheelchair, but we about to see what's up.
Yeah, well, don't waste people's time.
Somebody was holding the mic for him.
Yeah, so, and he got what is it? What did Muhammad Ali have?
Parkinson's. That's what it is.
He got Parkinson's, too. Awesome.
Golly.
Yeah. What do you think, man? Famous people don't get sick?
That ain't it. We're talking Jesse Jackson, the first dude that ran for president.
Yeah, but he didn't.
Did you vote for him?
I wasn't old enough to vote.
Well, I would, but
Father Time.
It's like Cornel West. Why would you vote for somebody that Father has no Time. Chance of winning?
Right.
It's like throwing away your vote.
It's like, but he was in like it. He's 81 for all y'all that's putting him up in the 86s and stuff. He's 81.
That what I said he was 81?
Yeah. And he just said, I came in here.
He walked a lot of steps in this.
And I'm leaving here walking on my own power. I came in here in a wheelchair, and I'm leaving here walking on my own power. So he just used it to rest.
No, bro.
I'm just saying what he just said.
I'm just telling you, I see the man. I'm not saying he can't walk. I'm saying, obviously, the wheelchair is not just for convenience. Yeah. I'm saying, you're having trouble walking. Hey, man, Andrew Young in a wheelchair.
You mean walk from the wheelchair to the truck?
Andrew Young got
an
electric wheelchair. I mean, he be rolling, too, boy.
He be rolling the wheelchair.
Mary Young is in a wheelchair. I didn't know that.
Yeah, man, in the back of
you don't know what's going on in the wheelchair world, man.
I'm off, man. I'm off.
But you can roll the wheelchair up to the van instead of walking to the van.
You ain't got to roll the wheelchair. Yeah, you got the little remote thing.
Yeah, Andrew, the little button. Not marching no more.
Andrew Young got like a go-kart.
Yeah. They play basketball in the wheelchair and everything. Yeah. They got a basketball league.
Now that you ain't got to be in that good shape for.
Mm-mm. Just upper body shape. Yeah, you do. Upper body. They be working out upper body.
They work
their upper body.
Look at Sister J being an expert on upper body.
You ever seen them cats?
They work their upper body.
You seen them handicapped guys that be laying down, rolling them bicycles with their arms?
Yeah, man. Them dudes look like cartoon characters.
No, they strong.
Huh? They real strong.
Don't grab you now. You might grab somebody. If they grab you.
Oh, it's a wrap.
You don't need no legs to choke
you.
It's a wrap.
You don't need no legs to choke you out.
It's over. Them dudes
that'd
like that.
That's another sport that's hard.
That'd be
swimming.
A shame. Man with no, swimming is man with no really legs with your ass, boy.
Swimming is hard, too.
Yeah, swimming. You got to be in shape.
Them guys be in shape. They've been swimming. You ever seen them guys?
Yeah. Them guys and that transgender girl, too. She got a lot of muscles.
Yeah, man. She got a really big muscle, too.
I think she got rid of that.
No, y'all she still got that muscle.
No, surely she ain't. Surely she done had the operation if they let her stay in the.
Man, y'all let up, man. Y'all already hit me with Tedder Pendergrass last week. Let's let up on this transgender.
Now, hold on, let's speak on that. Now, Dwayne Wade just bought a part of WNBA franchise in Chicago.
That's a good question you had. Go ahead, bro.
And now, do you think if his son decides to, son, daughter, whatever it is, decide to play basketball when she get to that level, we'd be an advocate for letting transgenders into the WNBA since he's the owner now?
I don't think that's right.
I hope he start out as a champion.
That's a hell of a question.
I hope they file the heck out
right.
of him.
I don't care. I don't think that's right. Just because you change your sex to be a female, you still are a man.
Physically.
And I know the community may be upset with me, but your chemical makeup is a man. I don't want to play physical. Thank you, makeup is a man. I don't want to play with a transgender who was born a man because it's not fair. That's not a fair competition. It's not fair.
And that's a good admission by a woman because I agree with you. But the reason it's such a good admission by a woman because you are admitting that. In the athletic world and physically, men are superior.
Oh, yeah.
Now, there would be no problem if a girl wanted to get into the NFL if she had the ability. Yeah. But that ain't going to hardly happen.
That ain't going to happen. That's too
far. Because there are some natural differences between men and women.
I don't think a woman should be playing football against a man.
We had one on our show before named J-Rock.
Yeah.
She tried out for the men's team and made it to the.
And I mean, when she took her shirt off one day, she looked like T.O. I swear to you.
Yeah, I remember you was talking about that.
I'm telling you, man. Yeah. I said.
I tell you this. When she took her shirt off, last thing you thought about was sucking her titty.
She had on one of them sports bras.
She took her shirt off, blouse off, whatever you want to call it.
I'm telling you, man. She looked like T.O.
Yeah. But I'll tell you, when everybody talks about...
Who was that female boxer that wanted to challenge Mayweather? It was a female boxer.
Oh, that's some street.
And I was like, Mayweather would demolish you.
Well, they was talking about Ronda Rousey could beat Mayweather.
She got her ass whipped by another woman.
Amanda Nunes whooped her.
Beat her ass.
Forced her into retirement.
Yeah.
Big time. She lost to Holly Holmes and Amanda Nunes. Oh. But, you know, we talk about Dwayne Wade's son. But I'm telling you who's big, and I saw him on Instagram recently. And it's a dude, but... dresses like a female all the time. And that is Magic Johnson's son, EJ. That dude is huge,
He's taller than 6'9", man.
Yeah, I'm saying 6'11". I'm like looking at this
dude.
That's
a woman. I don't care what y'all say. Yeah, man. That is a woman.
Look, man, if EJ went to the WNBA, it is unfair.
EJ, Magic Johnson's son, I call him Tragic Johnson.
And listen,
that
man.
Is a woman. I don't care what you say.
Who, EJ?
EJ is a woman.
I mean, maybe.
I think Brittany Griner beat him, though, because he can't play with that high heels on. So
he's a big dude. Yeah. I ain't taking nothing from Brittany Griner, but if you put EJ and let him train for 3 months, Brittany ain't going to do nothing with that man.
So what are they going to do? Because transgenders, they want to play sports. So how do you make it fair?
Give them their own
league. They should want to learn how to make business.
They should. Why sports? Why they got to get a sport? Why they can't be a good housewife or mechanic or some shit? You know what I'm saying?
Get some flip-flops and call it a day.
Why they want to invade just sports? They invade all of it.
Because you had the girl, transgender girl, that beat all the women in the swimming thing.
Yeah. He should.
But that's my point. That's not fair.
He's taller.
Hey,
man, I want a track and field. Red out. That's not fair.
You have a different type of strength.
That's right.
Than what a naturally born woman have.
That's right.
So what are they gonna do?
I saw Jenna. What's his name?
Caitlyn Jenner
at a golf tournament for women. That motherfucker hit the ball so far, man.
You mean Bruce?
See what I'm saying? I'm quit.
You mean Bruce?
I wouldn't even play.
He switched his ass up to your miniskirt. He switched his ass up to a tee ball. Yes.
Did they let him swing from the women's tee?
Yes. He should be ashamed of himself. He was a scratch golfer as a man.
As a dude, yeah.
He switched his ass up there to that tee box in that miniskirt. And that son of a bitch hit the ball, and the rest of the women that was supposed to be all with him, you know, she's a woman now, she's a woman. Yeah. They was like, this shit, what the hell going on?
Yeah, why are we here?
That's my point.
He hit the ball out of sight, brother.
All right, why are we here?
I wouldn't even play.
Hey, can I ask y'all a question?
Look at this. So
I wouldn't even play.
I'm 100% disabled veteran. That doesn't mean I can go to the Special Olympics and compete against them disabled children. And take all their medals.
Right.
No, because they have physical handicaps.
You got a mental. And you got a mental.
No, look, mine's about 10% mental. The rest of it is.
That does not qualify.
They don't have mental.
But that's my point, though. Like, they should have a transgender Olympic game.
You want to be a transgender mental.
If you're a transgender, you have your own Olympic game.
I don't think it's that many of them.
Well, then, I mean, look. The thing I don't like is they're taking the medals away from these girls that or young ladies that deserve it.
That's my point.
They're robbing them right now.
I agree.
And they're messing up their stats and all kind of different things.
And you can do what you want to do. Hey, be who you want to be. Do what you want to be. Do what you want to do. I don't care. All I'm saying is when it comes to things like that, it's not fair.
Exactly.
It's not fair.
If one come out there against my niece's soccer team, I'm tackling.
Don't be putting my children in that. No, change that. Don't be putting my son. Change that.
But if it's a girl out there,
don't change that.
No, Sister J, I feel you. If you got a daughter that's out there and he playing against a dude, I'm tackling him, Sister J.
That's a good question, JJ. That's a good question.
If he was what?
If your son playing sport, it was a girl on the other team, would you want him to, like, hit him like a man or be soft on the girl? Would you want him playing against a girl?
I would not want him. So if you're saying the girl decided to be a transgender playing on the sport with him.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wouldn't want him playing because that's not fair.
Bumped that.
Now you're restraining my son.
He should knock her out.
Let me finish. Listen to you.
Yeah.
You're making my son because of how he was trained and raised. So he's going to be a little bit more reserved with playing against her. So that's not fair to him.
Okay.
But then she'll take advantage, and mm-hmm. he'll be forced to put in his strength. Mm-hmm. And then if he was to knock on her behind, then it's, oh, my God.
Right.
So I just wouldn't want him to do it. I wouldn't want him to play.
Have been out.
That's not fair to him. Because right me now, being a competitive parent, I'm like, hey, man, you got to win.
Yep.
Yeah, my 17-year-old son did wrestling last year as a junior.
Put him back in the band.
And now they're letting girls, you know, wrestle with the boys.
Yeah, I wrestled in high school, but
I
wouldn't feel good body slamming a woman who hadn't done nothing to me.
And that's my point. My son was like,
who haven't done anything to me.
Because he was good at it.
I wouldn't feel good.
Who haven't done anything to me.
I wouldn't feel good body slamming.
No, look, exactly. Look, my son, he was saying, you know, I can't do this no more because I'm not giving it my all because it's a girl and I don't want to hurt her.
You don't want to lose. And you don't want to lose. But,
well, you better go out there and earn that scholarship.
No, he didn't want to lose, but he was just like, I don't want to hurt these girls.
Yeah, it's a mental.
You're gonna be a little compassionate. If you're a real man, you're gonna be a little softer too.
A little bit.
Because another thing, you can't grab her nuts.
Because if it was another boy, man, he probably would have crushed him.
He'd crush it.
But you're right.
But the whole mentality is different.
Yeah.
But you're right, Bullhead. My son, he wrestled too, and one of his teammates, they had to go up against a girl, and she was doing her thing, and the guy was like, "Man, I can't lose against her," and
bust
bam,
on her head.
Yeah, and then the parents was like, "Oh my God, I'm."
You got in there. What you think?
What you think is supposed to happen?
She went back to home ec next week. I'm gonna take home ec.
I'm gonna learn how to cook.
She beat one guy. And I think she beat that guy because he was like, I can't do this.
Simping
but the next guy was like, hey, man, I can't let this girl beat me.
Simping
and it was not so, it wasn't so much of a girl. It was like that I need to win this match.
Yeah.
So now he went into his competitiveness, and he won the match.
Guess what? The one guy she beat, she married him.
You're so stupid. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
We'll be back. You're listening to DISRACE Live.
She married him.
Philo Padone. Philo Padone.
ladies and sisters. You ain't gonna slap me.
Yeah. I slapped him.
That girl scratched my neck wrong.
Well, if y'all saw some smoke in the air around you, it ain't me.
Nope.
Canada's on fire.
On fire. Makes
no sense. Smoker in Chicago, smoker in New York. You know, about a couple months ago, they stopped the ball game in New York. They said it was too smoky to play.
The air quality is slowly getting down.
And y'all
were
laughing when Herschel Walker said, we cleaning the air up and then the Chinese breathing it. Y'all was laughing. Oh, Herschel was right.
Yeah.
They started wearing masks again.
Huh?
In New York City, is wearing masks.
Yeah.
From the air quality.
Well, this heat, this heat ain't
Chicago
doing
too.
This heat is.
They suggested you wear masks, huh?
This heat is killing people around the country too, man.
It's hot,
hot.
It's hot, man. It be hot in the morning.
Earth is warming up, man.
Water in Florida is even hot.
Yeah, they said the water in the Gulf is like 95 degrees.
Earth is warming up, man.
Yeah, global
heat. Yeah. Water the first time, fire the second time.
And they said,
what
y'all
about?
The Antarctica, it's throwing out.
Lord, please, Lord, not yet.
And yeah, what? In Antarctica, it's throwing out so fast, they found a gonorrhea strand
that's
1,000 times stronger than
No, they didn't. Yeah. I can't let him get away with that with DC.
He's not making that up.
Yeah.
They stop it.
They thawed out in Antarctica. They found a block ice that had gonorrhea.
Oh, they thought. Oh, I see what you're saying.
Stronger than what?
I didn't know it's stronger. Stop
it.
They tested it. Like everything else.
Thousand times stronger.
They might test it on some.
They took
mice or monkeys.
They took 33 Tuskegee.
black people.
Exactly. I was gonna say some Tuskegee people or some inmates of the prison.
They found a strain of gonorrhea 1,000 times stronger.
Sister J, please, can you back that up, please?
Yeah.
Gonorrhea strain.
I heard about that.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
God.
They said it was stronger than fentanyl.
I know y'all, but gonorrhea strain?
I don't know if they said 1,000 times, but it's stronger than...
We'll call it the fentanyl chlamydia strain.
But listen up. If you're talking about gonorrhea and you test it on animals and it's 1,000 times strong, I mean, whatever they use, leaking and the pain that you're subjecting that animal to, I mean, like,
that's a dirty rat.
We should be punished.
Was gonorrhea painful?
I don't know. I'm on her story.
You just said
yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
Icebergs and that.
When they say,
but yeah, that, it's
when they say
you
be pissing like razor blades.
Yeah,
is that right?
Yeah.
You had
they say it's thawing. They say the seals and polar bears.
I heard a lot of motherfuckers scream though.
They ain't got nowhere to go. Ain't enough snow and ice.
Yeah, for the polar bears. Yeah.
The polar bears don't have nowhere to go.
Man, they say they about to be a snake.
Antarctica is melting.
Yeah, they said they about to die off.
Seals and
they ain't gonna die off. They'll adapt.
No, seriously, they said that they're about to become a snake.
Dang, how?
They can't survive in the summer.
They can't survive if it ain't no winter. They need the snow, man.
They're a polar bear, not a
I understand.
A heater bear.
Watch they adapt.
Yeah.
Watch they adapt.
Huh?
If you can feed them, they're going to adapt.
I don't know about that. What happened to the dinosaurs?
How you going
to
feed them?
Couldn't feed them.
Most people can't even get to
that. They feed their damn self. What do you mean?
And the things that they eat also
the food supply
water,
that they had.
So they're dying too.
And then whatever. With the dinosaur, I guess stuff blacked out. You just couldn't feed them.
Well, nobody feed no dinosaurs. They feeding the damn self.
The food supply, the type of things that they ate, certain other dinosaurs and stuff like that. I don't know if seals and stuff was right, but I think other dinosaurs and stuff.
Seal dying.
They're moving. They move into a different area because the ice is moving, so the seals are moving, so the polar bears.
Oh, it's a fact that animals can become extinct.
I agree.
They've gone in and done, the scientists have gone in and protected certain animals because they are becoming extinct.
Right.
But most of that's because they were being hunted, not because of, the food.
Well, in the case of black men, yeah, it's because we're being hunted. But I'm talking about the animals out there in the wild.
Yeah.
Well, the whale was killed for the tar.
Getting the elephants for the tusks.
Rhinos and
last of the dough birds. Huh? Bugs Bunny used to do a cartoon called Last of the Dodo Birds because the Dodo Birds used to be extinct. And they were like a little character on Bugs Bunny talking about, I'm the last of the Dodo Birds. So, I mean,
I don't get that at all.
One Dodo Bird.
I don't get that at all. But
I'm saying you're saying they protested and they found one Dodo Bird when they thought the Dodo Bird was extinct. They found
them. Okay.
Well, right now, the only way they can actually keep them.
And where were you hiding?
Put them in a zoo.
I look, man. I don't go
you,
by.
Are you a dodo bird, man?
No, I'm saying the way they can preserve animals is by putting them in zoos now.
Yeah, but you can't keep enough animals. I mean, keep them. They just had a baby gorilla. They've been trying to get that gorilla pregnant for years at the Atlanta Zoo. So they got to protect them from the hunters and stuff like that.
Why do you think it's like when you say you preserve them in a zoo, but something like the great white shark, the only way it can exist is in the wild? Like you can't, even with that big giant aquarium in Dubai, they tried to capture a couple of great whites and they won't stay alive. Yeah. Like, why do you think, you just say you get animals to survive in the zoo, but that's true, I guess, in most exceptions,
they got polar bears except for the
great white shark.
I don't know. Mm-hmm. That's a very good question, Reverend.
But, so why do y'all think the polar bear can't make it?
I don't know. Bullhead just said they got polar bears in the zoo, so I guess they make it.
They got polar bears in just about every zoo.
I'm just saying, y'all saying the polar bear gonna go extinct. I don't think that's true. I think they're gonna adapt.
You know, they cool the water down so they can survive.
So let me ask you this.
Sure.
If it used to be, and I'm just throwing this number out there.
Sure.
But if it used to be 500,000 polar bears, all right?
Right.
You with me? And now it's only 200,000 polar bears. What makes you think they cannot become extinct? There is a scientific fact that there are less now than there were 10, 15 years ago. So what makes you think
that's because they were being hunted? Well, if we protect them and don't hunt them, then they won't go down.
But polar bears were being hunted? That's the reason.
I guarantee that's what's contributed to it, those big game hunters.
More so than the climate change.
To a polar bear's extinction, I would say it comes from more of hunting than climate change.
Global warming.
I'm gonna say that.
Okay.
Why Negroes being extinct? That's what we need to be worried about.
That's why I said the black man is the only animal hunted down, and then he ain't got no tusks. Mm-hmm. He ain't got no fur worth a damn. He just for fun.
And they want to put you in the ground.
There's a theory out there, DC, that I heard on the internet, right?
Yeah.
That the black man is hated because of his sword between his legs.
Mm-hmm. And love, too.
And that's what it said.
They're the most hated and the most loved.
Hold on a second.
Well, they're just going to have to hate me.
I have
now, if you want to not be hunted, and that's why you think they're hunting you, get yourself fixed. They'll do it. Yeah. But they just gonna have to hate me.
That is the power of the world. A black man can change lives with his sword. Mm. White women, black women, whoever come in contact with it.
I got someone that's watching the show who's a microbiologist. She said that gonorrhea ice thing, she said the same thing I said. Stop it. So she's a microbiologist. So she don't think the gonorrhea ice thing.
No.
She's saying that that's not true. I mean,
she's saying that's not true.
I don't know about 1,000 times stronger, but I did hear somewhere on the news somewhere that some diseases thawed out of that ice.
And something we culture gono in 25-year-old's blood this weekend. He's septic with it. Ridiculous. So I just took her back. Is it true?
Ask her, have she tested some of these?
ask her what something. She's watching some.
Now, RFK said, crazy ass Robert Kennedy, talking about running for president now. He said that COVID was designed to settle the black man, he said, and the Caucasian man down, and he said something else crazy this week.
To sort of Caucasian man down?
Yeah, cool. That's what he said.
Wow.
RFK. Oh, and he said there's some chemicals in some food or something. And he said that's what's making all the children gay.
Yeah.
Oh, well, my God.
They've been saying that for years that, you know. But what? My thing is.
What, suckers?
Stop eating Fruit Loops now.
The commercials kill me. They have a commercial where they say, if you're not classified at birth as a woman, don't take this drug. Why you still say it ain't for women? Don't that make sense to say it's not for women?
You can't say that because no, some men have changed their sex to being a woman, so that's why they're saying
it's not for men.
If you wasn't classified.
No, it is for men. It's for gay men. But it say if you wasn't classified as a woman at birth, don't try this drug.
Wow.
So I'm confused.
Hold on, say that again.
You know what? I'm saying back in the day.
If you was classified as a woman.
You saying it back.
Yeah.
If you're not classified at birth as a woman.
If you're not a woman. Classified. All your life.
I assume.
Don't take this drug. In other words, the drug is for men.
Right. So why just say it's not for women?
I think they're saying if you was classified as a woman at birth. I think that's what they probably
said. Not classified.
Hey, you remember the commercial back in the day? Secret deodorant?
Yeah.
Made for
a man.
Strong enough for a man, but made for a woman. Yeah.
And now they got Old Spice. So now they trying to wear men's cologne.
Wait, whoa. Are you saying they got Old Spice for women? Or that the women are just wearing Old Spice.
Yeah. One of the commercial,
well, that commercial Old with Dion Cole.
Men. Right, it's for men.
Yeah.
Old Spice was made for men.
Yeah. But what they trying to say, women are using it now or something?
Yeah, that's their
little
thing.
That's what they imply.
I wish I would meet a woman talking about wearing some Old Spice.
Why not? Just women like, do like wear it, so you met women.
Out. Get out.
Women wear men cologne.
Get out.
They got to. If they want to be a man. Oh, my God.
Some what?
Get out.
Some of them got musty balls.
So you agree with me when I say get out. I wish you would bring your bag over to my spot and you bring out some Old Spice. We ain't going to make it.
Some women wear men cologne. Just like some men wear women cologne.
Okay.
Perfume.
But Brian, if you a man, you'll be drawn to a
No, I won't.
Well, I will tell you, I have never tried Secret deodorant under my armpits.
If you're a man like a man, you won't.
Gone.
Well, since we got vets here, it's a different subject, but since we got vets here, I want y'all's military opinion. Travis, what's the boy's name? He's a soldier over there, and he crossed the line in North Korea.
Oh, yeah, my son told me about that.
And he black, too.
Yeah. Oh, I asked my son. He said he didn't know.
Yeah. He black. And I guess he thought it was a game or he was trying to do a TikTok or something. They say, and the woman said he stepped over. She said, I thought it was a joke. And when he stepped over that line into North Korea.
Got your ass.
They said, get him. Yeah. And they grabbed his ass and he's in captivity now. What? Now, United States, they don't tell how many millions of dollars going to be spent trying to get that boy back.
Stop playing with people.
I heard that he stepped over line because he was trying to avoid being in trouble. He was in trouble
in the military for doing something. They were talking about putting him out. I think he was just being a smart
ass. But the mom said.
Yeah, stepped over there and them North Koreans. Them North Koreans like, nigga, you think we playing?
Right, mm-hmm. Right. Like, you don't want to be stuck in North Korea before you go home.
His mama said he met a girl over there he liked. He didn't want to come back. He wanted to go over there. That's what his mama said.
That's
what
she's going to be writing him letters
that
while
sound,
he locked
that
up.
That sound about like he saw a little white toddler walking down North Korea. Right. Yeah, but he went over there.
If you go over there like that, you ain't going to see him for 20 years.
Well, they are in negotiation to get him back.
No, the government said no. Well, they came in voluntarily. Huh? They saw on camera. He voluntarily went.
He was testing it. The line, there's a line, man.
Uh-huh, right.
And he was like, doo-doo. And they like snatched his ass.
What'd he do?
I bet you won't. Hey, bet you won't step across this line. You know you do that when you're in the kid. Bet you won't step across this line. Bet you won't step across this line.
And the last time I got hit. Trust me.
I know an ex-police officer that shot a boy like that.
Mm.
And he says, you know. I know for a fact he shot him.
Overzealous.
He told the guy was walking up on him, white guy with baseball bat. Mm. He was hitting golf balls in a white neighborhood. And white boy got out with, carjack handle. And walked up to him. He didn't know he was a police. He was just out there in the field hitting some golf ball. Mm. And the white boy said, you know, what you doing out here, nigga? And he said, man, gone with that shit. I'm hitting some golf balls. And he started walking toward him. And the guy that I'm talking about, police, Shaq. You know Shaq, don't you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Shaq told him, when he got about 6 feet away, you take one more step, and I'm gonna bust a cap in your ass. So the boy, trying to be funny, took one step, and Shaq shot him in the head.
Damn! Mm. In the head? He had to do that one?
He lived him.
Shaq a bad shot. He's a bad shot.
He shot him in the leg.
Did he
get in trouble for it?
Yeah, I mean it was a big deal, but he didn't go. He was still on the police force. He got out.
So what the white boy? What the white boy do though?
When he got shot in the head, he went down.
But before he got shot, he said, "You come one step with that."
He said, "Take one more step."
I wonder what he did.
The white boy said.
Man, listen.
He lit it up.
Man, that's got to be a scary feeling when that skillet hits you. You talking all that noise and that skillet hits you, man, it's a whole different mindset. Gosh.
And then once it went down, Shaq
why
said,
"Why you shoot me?"
No, yeah, he said, "Nigga, why you shoot me?" And Shaq said, when he said that, I ain't going to say. But anyway, he did some more damage to him. Not with the gun, but.
Mm-hmm.
Now I got to stump a mud hole in you. For saying the N-word.
The more story, I'm going to drive home all night with people and crossing the line with them.
Yeah, you cross that line if your ass want to.
Yeah, you know, already, we was walking on thin ice when he said N-word to him.
Well, he
was
walking on N-word. Yeah, right.
That's what I'm saying. You already on thin ice. You playing with your life right there when you say that.
But this boy, I don't know what he was thinking, but you can't just go to somebody else's country and act like, what, because you American, you think, I know
keep
y'all
on.
Military.
You got some boastful Americans out there
you
like that.
Keep cause, on. Just because you're American, you can do whatever the hell you want to do.
I don't. I definitely respect
Well, you know, before we go anywhere, we have
to get a briefing. Yep.
You got to get a briefing for that country. Yep. So they tell you.
You military too, Will? Oh, okay.
No.
So they tell you, it's called a SOFA brief, Status of Forces Agreement, with that country. So they'll tell you, don't do this, don't do that. I think it's kind of stupid to tell them not to do it, because when you tell them not to do it, they do that shit.
Yeah, but they can't say they wasn't told.
Yeah. No, right.
Exactly.
But
I told you, don't step over that line, nigga.
But they didn't tell you, but they didn't know about it until they told them about it. So, like, we left two Marines and a sailor in Turkey one time because they told us if anybody tries to sell you hashish, don't try to buy it. These three guys tried to buy something from an undercover cop. They spent 2 years in prison there in Turkey.
So you said.
I don't even feel bad for them.
You said.
I don't feel bad for them either.
It's better to not tell stupid motherfuckers not to do something.
Yeah.
And then they don't know not to do.
No.
I mean.
No, you may have three, but you won't have 3,000.
I know what you're saying, though. It's there. Like, I don't do good with threats myself. Yeah. I ain't going to do nothing stupid like that.
Right.
But I don't do good. I mean, so it's like daring a guy. Or threatening. If you do that, you're gonna. I don't do good with threats.
Yeah, like the first place I went in my life was Rome, and when you go to Italy, they say you can't do this.
But why would used to do it all the time?
But why would you tell all of these Americans not to do that?
Snoopy used to do it all the time.
It's not offensive. But why would you tell them to do
that?
Stop it. I'm telling you. Because
you may have some guys from New York who've done that before. There may be some recruits from New York who do that all the time.
Snoopy, come home.
It's also helping you understand their culture. When I was in college and we were learning different cultures when you're dealing in business, it's not so much that they're threatening you, they're preparing you, because if you don't know the culture, then you don't know what to do now.
And you could be over there and your chin be itching, you do this, and then you say, nigga.
And when they were teaching you, they told you, don't have your top too low.
Well, you know what?
Well, I mean, that's what did they teach you that?
Boo said get your shot in some countries.
Dang, JJ, you got to memorize.
I'm telling you.
Why you going to get your shot in some countries?
Low-cut shirt.
Don't have your top too low.
But you know what,
though? You think that's too low?
I don't think it's low enough.
I'm sure Sister JJ would know in certain countries that you would you have to wear certain clothes, correct?
Said it again.
I said you would know what country to go to and dress a certain way, right?
Oh, yeah, you know they prepare you before you go to different places.
Oh, yeah. She was over in, not Saudi Arabia. Where is it? Iran now. Oh, she get about 20 years for that.
Yeah,
she I'm standing right here in beautiful America.
Take her head
20
off.
20 years each titty.
We're going to cut it off.
You listen to this race. I'm DZ Curry.
Cover it up. I'm Bo B.
I'm Sister JJ.
I'm Mohawk Minister.
It's your man Bullhead, the Forest Muslim Gump. Peace and blessings.
You got too many titles.
We'll holler.
Bo P is right. She hit me up. Just.